Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today I'm going to show you how to create a calculator using Visual Basic plus 2 minus 10 times 3 divided by 9 plus minus times 6, that's 180, negative 180. Now hit clear and it moves. Thank you for watching the video. Subscribe for our channel. And so the first thing, go to start button, type there Visual Basic and hit enter. In the window open, select new project, go to Visual Basic there, select Windows Form application and type here the project. Standard calculator, then hit OK. A form will open. So we are going to add some few stuff here, a bottom and text box, enlarge the size of the form, go to toolbox, select here a text box and also the bottom, move up, select the bottom. Then select all of them, select the two the text box and the form, go to properties tab here, select font, go to font, make a 22 bold, then click OK. Select the text box, drag up to the edge and move it up there, then select that icon, make it multiple line, then move it backward again, select the bottom, go to properties, in the properties section select the size, erase and type there 100 by 75, and the form size will be changed. So select the form, copy it, paste it, this is button 2, copy it, paste it again, button 3, copy it, paste it, select the form, add the size for button, copy, paste at the bottom here. We want to make almost 20. So we have almost 20 buttons. Resize back. again down there, so take it to the edge and there you go. So also select this one. Yeah, it's perfect. Okay, click bottom 2, then go to text box in the blueprint section. Go to text box, then erase everything. We are going to put our own label until you reach bottom 17. That is how I will be doing it. Select the first bottom. Now I have just did a few modification. You can do alone there. So select the first bottom, go to Word, then go to Insert tab, select symbols, a group of symbols, select symbol, go to more option, more symbols, type here windings, select here, you see a font which is written windings. Now let me repeat, select a symbol, more option, more symbol, type font here, winding. Now subset, select that small down arrow facing, then you will find a font here, then go down up to here, select this bottom which is backspace. So we shall be inserting that one, backspace, and also select a minus plus sign. Okay, then insert, close, then select the backspace, copy it, go to Visual Basic. Make sure you have to be selected in bottom, that bottom, go to text box, now paste it there. Now what we are going to do, we are going to go to font size, go to font, select it, type here windings, click OK, and that sign backspace is executed. Go to Word again, copy plus minus sign, go to Visual Basic, select this bottom, go to where it's written text box, paste it there. Yeah, it's executed. So in this bottom next to the backspace, select it, go to Brobert, type there CE, big CE. Now select here also, type C capital, which is clear. Okay, here type there in the text section plus sign. Also here, minus sign. Here should be multiplication. And here should be division. Now our form is ready. If I just debug it, it will look like this. Those things, they are not working, none of them. So we are going to code it right now in a fabulous way. So we stop the debug and go back to here. Now select text box, then go to name Then, yeah, then type here txt display, txt display, select this button here, also name it button 1, btn backspace, btn backspace. Now also this one, btn big C big E. Also this one, btn btn big C. Here type plus minus btn, I mean btn plus minus. Also here type btn 7, copy, go to here btn 8, btn 9, btn shift B up to down there, do it btn 4 like that until you finish up to. Okay, select the text box. Okay, go to text up here, select the text. Yeah, text here, boot 0, also text align, select there from right. Yeah, perfect. Okay, select all numeric numbers. After that, hold control, add 0 and decimal, go to properties, select from events here, under events select there select the click, mouse click here, yeah. So type there number underscore underscore click, hit enter. And here we are going to code. What I'm going to do is I'll be selecting these buts of the but from number 7 up to decimal point. So put your cursor here, highlight, hold control, click 0. Also decimal, go to events here, then where you see click, type there number, shift underscore, that's shift next 0 become underscore, type there click, then hit enter. When you hit enter, you will go to this interface, type there dim bs bottom be as button, as button, double T O N, equal to space send, space sender, hit enter to go on a space, if open bracket txt display dot text space equal to space quotation mark close quotation mark, inside the quotation mark put the zero, then close the bracket, hit enter, then you will see then will be typed automatically when you hit. So copy what you see inside this quotation mark from there up to here, up to txt, up to txt, copy it, and control C, let me put here control V, control V, type here 0, sorry for that, 0, that this one will be empty, again, txt, txt display dot text equal to b dot text, hit enter, then else if space open bracket b dot text space equal to quotation mark, put there point or dot close quotation mark, then close bracket, hit enter, then type there if space open bracket not txt display not okay, type there if space open bracket not space txt display dot text, dot text, dot contain, dot contains open bracket open quotation mark, put the dot close quotation mark close bracket, also close the bigger bracket, hit enter, then will be typed automatically txt dot display txt display dot text space equal to space txt txt display dot text space plus sign space type there also b dot text, then in this section and if hit enter here, go to else here, else space else enter, type that txt display dot text space equal to space txt display dot text plus sign b dot text, you can copy this line also, so the coding part's over, save, debug, let us see if the code is working. 7 8 9 6 5 4 1 2 0 decimal. All the numbers, they are working perfect. So what we are going to do now, we are going to call this backspace CE clear, plus, minus, multiplication, division, and equal sign. So now when we just type our numbers into this way, you see now how it is so smart. Include decimal 0, 1, 2. Now when I touch this backspace, it's not working. You see now, it's not functioning. So we are going to code this backspace now. What you do, double click this backspace. It prompts you to the coding part. Now type here if statement, if open bracket txt display txt display dot text dot length space greater than space 0 close bracket, hit enter, then it will be typed automatically. Txt display dot text space equal to txt display dot text dot remove open bracket txt display dot text dot length space minus space 1, space 1 close bracket, hit enter. After that when you run the code, then you type there 5, 4, 4, 8, 3, then you just backspace, it works, but it becomes here empty. Like now 4, 3, 0. Now when you when I hit backspace, it's okay, it's working. Now I want the backspace to be displayed 0. So it's working, but it's not displaying 0. So let us code that part of displaying 0. Go to end if, then hit enter, type here if open bracket, then txt display dot text. I will be copying this code, of course we can't type every now and then. Okay, copy that part, hit here control V, put here space, now space equal to space quotation mark, another quotation mark, close bracket, hit enter, then copy this part of txt display dot text, control C, then come here control V, put here 0. Put there 0, save, then be back. Let us see how it works. See, it's so fun. Backspace, it displays 0, perfect. Now we work on this backspace, will be also working. So we shall be taking care of plus, minus, multiplication, and division. So we are going to take care of plus, minus, multiplication, and division. So highlight here. After that, go to click, type there, number click, then hit enter. When you go here, then could be this dim B as button could be this statement, then go to here where we have handles here, then paste it. After that I declare some few things, come here and type dim first value comma second value comma result space as double. Now hit enter, then type dim as string. Dim as string. Dim OB as string. Remember, I did few things here. I highlighted plus, minus, division, subtraction, multiplication. Then I go to these events. Then just click, type here operation click, and hit enter. After that, I just type here dim B. I just copy that statement from up there, the code that we written earlier, then paste it, then go up the phone, then we type a value, first value, second value, and third value. Now here we are going to add some few stuff here. We are going to type first value equal to txt display or text dot text. Then we are going to add operator equal to b dot text. Then we are going to type here txt display dot text. Space equal to quotation mark. This one will take care of that. Now we are done here. First value, we go back to our form design. Then we are going to take care of the equal sign. So double click the equal sign, type there second value space equal to txt display dot text. Txt display dot text. Then hit enter. If operator or b space equal to space quotation mark, add here plus quotation mark close. Then result up here. Okay, rest those buts. Result equal to first value plus second value. First value plus second value. So we are going to type here txt display dot text dot text equal to result. Now, copy this part, which says if operator up to the result, copy it, type there, hit enter, else if space control V. Now here it should be minus, and here should be minus. That will, it will be taking care of our code. Remove this if. Yeah. So copy else if. Go to here. Control V. So this one should be a multiplication. This one should be a multiplication also. So go to again Control V. This one should be division, and also this one should be division. So I hope we are done. So here we are missing result. Of course, we don't copy also result. Add here result, copy, put here result, also put here result, also put here result. So now if we save and run the code, we get 8 plus 2, we have to get 10, and it's there. Now if we subtract 7 minus 4, we will be getting 3. Perfect. Now if we multiply 5 times 2, we will get something called 10. It's perfect, it's working. Now if we divide 18, 18 divided by 3, we get 6. Perfect. Now we are done the coding part of calculation. So let us take care of this plus and minus. Double click it. Now here type if space open bracket txt display dot text dot contain open bracket, type there quotation mark minus quotation mark, close the quotation mark and close the bracket, then hit enter. Then let us close the bracket, then hit enter. Okay, txt display dot text. Txt display dot text space equal to txt display dot text dot remove dot remove open bracket 0 space comma space 1 close bracket, hit enter. Txt display dot text, txt display dot text space equal to, oh no, let us type here else, and let us hit enter. Then txt display dot text space equal to space quotation mark minus plus quotation mark, then space balance space txt display dot text. Now let us run the program and see if it works everything. 7, 9 balance 4, that's 93 minus 3, that's 90 times times 2, that's 180 divided by 2, I mean divided by 3, or maybe 3, yeah, it is 60 plus minus times 2. What shall we get as result? 120. So that's how we are going to see if our buttons are working. Now this one is not working, this button, which is clear button, it's not working. Let us make it working. So double click this txt, then let us go and copy a certain code from up here. So txt display dot text, copy this code, copy this code, then come to the design side, double click this, then paste it, add here 0, then save the coding part, start running, debug the program. Let us see if these things working. Plus 2 minus 10 times 3 divided by 9 plus minus times 6, that's 180, negative 180. Now hit clear and it moves. Thank you for watching the video. Subscribe for our channel and comment it, and hit the bell icon so that you see another videos which are upcoming for the Barbers of Istanbul. Thank you for watching.